to Total Body Toning. My name is Ginger. I'm going to be your instructor for the next 45 minutes. And being that everybody's home, I want you to go ahead and get some things so you can utilize them in the class. A mat, maybe a towel if you don't have a mat. Get a sturdy chair. Make sure it's sturdy because we will be doing things where you sit on the front and also put your body weight on it so you don't want it to tilt. Couple sets of dumbbells, we have options like light and heavy. If you don't have dumbbells, don't worry about it. You can grab water bottles, you can grab cans of food, whatever you have around the house that would help, you know, to be resistance. Or you can also opt out of any weights and just use your own body weight. So those are all options for you. Anytime you feel like you need to stop or slow down, do it. Modify anything you need to. I'll also show you modifications, but please just take couple seconds of a break, catch your breath, and come right back. Try not to stop completely still. Okay, so we're gonna do a quick little warm up, and some of the exercises will be still warming up. So we're gonna take your shoulders back and hunch forward, back and hunch forward. Two more times. Last set. And you're gonna alternate shoulders and lift and lift. Make sure they're nice and relaxed, your neck. Soft knees. And toe tap, nice and easy, through the hips, toes, feet, and ankles are moving with your hips. So make sure you don't plant those feet. We're gonna do a little core twist with this. What we're trying to do is get that internal core temperature warmed up, ready to go for all your exercises. And then reach across. And then we're gonna reach up. Reach across again. Into that core twist. Keep tapping, but lift the toe up now. So you're gonna feel that calf. Still keeping your legs apart. Four more. Three, two, leg curls. Kick your butt. Make sure those knees are still soft. You don't wanna lock those kneecaps. Start feeling warmed up a little bit. Okay, we're gonna do four more of these. Step together. Lift the knee. Remember to pull your abs in when you lift that knee. Nice tall upper body, good posture. Four more. And step it out again. Step it out. Tap in front. You're going to tap and cross it all the way over. So now you're going to get a little bit more of that core twist again. All the way across. Last four. Tap front again. Lift the toe up. Keep tapping. Last one. Now you're going to hold that toe, opposite leg. Make sure you don't push on this leg that you're stretching, hyperextended knee. Rest your body weight on the opposite thigh. While you're leaving the toe up, take your chest down. Feel a little bit of stretch, release a little bit. And again, stretch and release. Now we're going to switch. Opposite leg, make sure you rest your body weight. Press down with the chest, keep that toe up. One more time. And release, center, rest your body weight. Pull in and stretch that back, release. One more time, deep breath. Exhale, round it up. Okay, grab your light set of weights or your water bottles. We're gonna start out light because we're still kind of warming up. It's up to you where you're comfortable to hold them. You can hold them here or hold them here. We're gonna step out to the right and step out to the left and do a side squat or a lateral squat. And then back together. If you still don't feel really warmed up, go ahead and do partials. As you feel nice and warmed up and limber, then you can take it down deeper. Be really careful on those squats that your knees aren't being pushed forward. Your butt goes back like you're gonna sit in a chair. Weight is on your heels and not your tiptoes. And again, anytime you need to modify, you can do modifications, which could be less reps. If we're doing 20, 25, you can do 10, 15. Or you can get rid of your dumbbells. And even if you're using weights, you get tired, you can always get rid of the weights and just continue the exercise. Couple more. Now we're gonna stay on the squat and pulse. And really start feeling that burn in those legs. Remember, abs are in. Take it low if you can. Should be burning. 4, 3, 2, 1, and release. Woo. Okay, it's optional if you want dumbbells again. And always hold one dumbbell if you prefer. I'm gonna hold both. This is gonna be for the quad, the front thigh. Actually, I'm gonna show you a side view. Okay. Make sure that you're not really close to the chair because it's too easy. You're using the chair to do all the work. You want to step out so you feel unstable and put the foot on the chair and relax it. And you're going to focus on this front quad. So you're going to take it down, watch your upper body so you don't lean forward too much. Nice and tall. We're going to do 20. Remember, if you're modifying, you can do less reps or get rid of your weight. Halfway there. One more. And shake it out. If you feel your opposite leg burning and working, that's normal because you are working it just by balancing it. Okay, other foot. Here we go, nice tall upper body, 20 reps. Take it down as far as you can, where you're comfortable to still control coming back up. Towards the front of your chair, you can hang on. You're gonna really feel your core muscles as well, but we're gonna really focus on the quads. You wanna make sure you flex completely as straight as you can, depending on your flexibility in your hamstrings. So you're gonna have your legs up like this and straighten them out. Squeeze, squeeze. Feel your stomach muscles engage as well. 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9, 10. Good job. You should have really felt the quads right here, right above the knee. You're going to stay in the same position, still way in the front of your chair so you can lean back, but don't lean on your chair. Just lean back, and you're going to pull your knees into your chest using your lower stomach. Reverse crunches. 9, 10. Hold it. We're going to pulse. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Three, two, one, and release it. I'm gonna throw in core exercises all throughout the class. Still using the chair. Now you can go ahead and use a dumbbell, or you don't need a dumbbell at all. You can feel this exercise without. You want the balancing leg close to the chair. Make sure you don't lock that kneecap. Find a good sturdy spot in your chair. And you're gonna bring that leg up because we're gonna focus on our glutes. And we're gonna do 30 small little presses. There's the first 10. One more set. Last lunge. And shake it out. Okay, we're gonna grab our heaviest dumbbell. Reason for this is because we're gonna work our back, and our back's a large muscle. So typically you can go heavy. Grab your chair. Same knee, same side, the arm is going to be on that. This is kind of like your workout bench. We're gonna do an upright row, so you wanna make sure that your abs are in and you don't wiggle the body around. Keep it isolated. Relax, pull that elbow up, bring it down right before it's completely extended, bring it right back up. You don't wanna let it go all the way down and relax, release the contraction. Or snap out your arm. The upper body from wiggling around. Abs are in tight. Five more. Last one. And release. Okay, we're going to switch sides. Make sure it's the same hand, same side of the leg that you're putting on the chair or your bench. Here we go, elbow comes all the way up into the rib cage. Don't let it completely straighten out. Abs in, don't wiggle your upper body. And release. Okay, we're gonna do some back flies. Finish up our back, and it's gonna be more upper back. So it's up to you if you wanna stick with the same weight. These are a little bit more tough because you're going further away from your body. So you might wanna go lighter. But we're gonna go for 15 reps. So I'm gonna show you side view so you can see how my back is. Instead of rounding over, which is common, that stretches your back. You wanna make sure that stick your bottom out. Go really low into a squat and arch your back. You wanna have a little concave, so that way you're protecting it. And we're gonna do back flies, we're gonna pull back. Remember, modifications, you can do less reps. Targeting the upper back. Got five more. One more. Ooh, you should have felt it like the rear shoulders, upper back. We go back to one and hold it with both hands. So we're gonna do multiple muscle groups. It's gonna really get your heart rate up. You're gonna take it down in a squat, bring it back in and press up. Down into a squat, press up. Different muscle groups. Get arms, shoulders, chest, and obviously legs with the squats. Five more. Again, modify if you need to. Two more. And shake it out. Okay, we're gonna stick with this one. It's front shoulder, so if shoulders burn really quick, so you could go with a lighter weight, but we're gonna use both arms at the same time with the same weight. So that should make it not as difficult. Soft knees, abs in. You're gonna do a shoulder raise in the front. Do not go higher than your shoulders. And don't rest at the bottom right here. Remember those knees, don't walk those kneecaps. It's pretty common. When you walk your knees, it's a lot of strain in the lower back. rested at the bottom, right before it's completely rested, we go right back up. 5 minutes. And shake it out. Okay, we're going to alternate shoulders. You might want your light dumbbells because again, shoulders burn really quick. We're gonna do a set of 10 because we just did a lot of shoulders, so we're gonna kind of burn them out right now. Remember, don't hold your weights and rest them on your body like this. You wanna hold them up so they're still in contraction mode. Abs are tight and your knees are soft. So we're gonna press, hold it right here, press. Remember, don't rest it on your shoulder. That's 2, 3, 4, 5, halfway there, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. You should really feel those because we just did two other exercises that targeted your shoulders. Okay, we're going to biceps. So it's up to you, your level of fitness, if you want to go heavy or light. We're going to go ahead and do a one-arm bicep curl. It's standard. So it's regular standard, straight ahead. Make sure that your wrist, this is common, especially with women, to torque the wrist like this. Make sure that wrist stays cupped. So when it's in the extension, it doesn't fall back. So watch your wrist, check it every once in a while, keep it cupped, you can rest your body weight. This is like my little table right here, put your elbow right there, and then you're gonna curl it up, stay about 4 or 5 inches away from your body, because that's a rest spot, a little space there. I call it a nothing space. We're gonna do 15. Bracing it against your body helps it to be more isolated. As you can tell, you feel it. Five more. Check your wrist. Last one. And switch. Okay, brace it against your body. Check that wrist, cup it, curl it up, stay 4 or 5 inches away from your body. Check your wrist every so often. Okay, we're gonna do 5 more. One more. And release. Okay, we're gonna finish off our biceps. And because you just did some biceps, you might want your light weights, because we're doing another set of bicep exercises right after that first one, so they're gonna be pretty fatigued. This time though, instead of straight ahead, basic bicep curl like that, we're gonna take it out just slightly, an inch or two. Every quarter of an inch changes the exercise. We're still working the biceps, but it's a different angle. So again, keep those elbows in, don't let them float around. Here we go, we're gonna curl, check your wrists when they go down. Same thing applies. Wrists are always cupped. And you're at an angle, just a couple inches out. Almost like the letter V. Feeling these. Remember, you can modify it as well. You can do less reps. We're doing 15, you can do 10. One more. And shake it out. Okay, going back to one arm. Now we're going to the triceps. You just did the front of the arm. We're gonna do the back of the arm. Soft knees. If you need to, you can also sit in your chair and do this. You don't have to stand. You can sit down in the chair. Make sure your arm doesn't float around. You want to have your arm next to your ear, and it should stay there. So you want to bend behind your head. Make sure it doesn't go all the way down like this, parallel to the floor, so you're not pulling on that elbow. And then you're going to extend up, straighten it, bend, straighten, squeeze that tricep muscle, which is the back of the arm. Watch that arm down here so it doesn't float around, still next to the ear. Make sure you don't go out like this. That's a common mistake too, and that tears up the rotators, your shoulders. So you want to make sure your body is really close to the edge of the chair. Your back is parallel with it. You're going to go straight down the back. Further out your legs, the more advanced it is. So if you're just starting back, you want to bring your feet in so that your legs can kind of help you. But the further out you go, or holding at one, crossing, a little bit more advanced. So those of you that are advanced, get your legs out, way out in front. So we're gonna bend and straighten. Bend and straighten. Don't go too low, because then also that puts stress on your shoulders. Remember, your back is right next to the chair. Using those triceps. Five more. Feel that, because you just did a tricep exercise right before that. Okay, we're gonna go down to the mat or your towel. Have your weights next to you. We're gonna be utilizing them. Okay, we're going to chest, shoulder, front shoulder, anterior. We're going out far from our body, so that makes it more difficult, so you might want a lighter weight. And to add a little bit more stomach with it, we're going to have our legs up. At any time your stomach is burning, you can't take it too much more, you can bring your feet back down. Okay, so legs up. Make sure that your wrist doesn't fall back. You're gonna bring it down like a butterfly. This is the chest fly, what we're gonna do one at a time. So really close to the ground, don't rest it. Bring it up to the center. You're gonna pass it and take it back down to the other side. Bring it back up, pass it. You wanna make sure you're slow and controlled, because this is a position when you go out far from your body. If you move too quickly, you can tear your rotator cuffs. So make sure you use control, cup that wrist. Watch that wrist as it gets close to the floor. Cup it, don't let it fall back. Remember, you should be feeling your stomach right now as well because your legs are up. If you have to put your feet down, go for it. What's great about these exercises, when you use one side, the upper body, the opposite side of your waist works. So I'm actually working my right oblique. Now I'm working my left oblique. It automatically kicks in to counterbalance you. Got a few more of these. You bring your legs down if you need to. Okay, last one. And last one on this side. And bring those feet down. Okay, we're gonna target more of the lats, the sides of your back. You are still gonna get a little bit of the shoulder, so remember, don't move quickly through this movement. We're trying to keep our arms as straight as we can, so when we're lengthened, when we pull up, we're working our lats. Our lats are engaged to bring that weight back up. If you bend your elbow, it's more tricep, and this is relaxed. So we want to make sure we completely straighten out that arm. So again, I'm going to use the same weight. If you feel like you can go heavier, go heavier. You're going to do one arm. You're going to bring it back as far back as you can. If you can touch the floor, great. And then bring it back up, squeezing your lats. Back down. Of this exercise is really keeping that arm straight. We got five more. It's much harder to do one arm at a time than the most common exercise. You hold the dumbbell with both arms and go back. Much more difficult. And what I like about these exercises with one arm, we usually have one side that dominates. And so if you use them together like this, the dominant one's gonna do more of the work. So this way you keep them both just as strong. Okay, other side, bring it down. Remember, straight arms, so you engage that lat muscle. Slow and controlled. If you can't touch the floor, don't worry. Everybody's flexibility in the shoulders is different. Focus on keeping that arm straight and squeezing right here on the side of your back. Last one. And release it. Good job. Okay, we're going to grab both dumbbells, and we're going to do, you might want your heavier ones because we're coming closer to the body, and that's a little bit easier than, you know, further away. Legs up, unless you're modifying. You're going to do your regular chest presses, so you're going to turn. As soon as your elbows kind of touch the ground, don't rest them. As soon as they touch, bring them back up, touch together, touch the floor, back up. If your legs up is too much, put your feet back down. We're going to do 15. Like doing a push-up. Got five more. Last one. Roll it up. Focusing on the obliques, your left hand goes, you're going to turn to your side, prop your yourself up, shoulder right on top of that elbow. You want your legs straight, but out in front of your body so you're balancing on that hip ball joint. Make sure you don't put your hand back behind you. That's another common mistake, is it torques your spine. So you don't want to twist back. You're just kind of lined up, or you can put your hand on the ground. So bring it up, and we're going to lift for 10. Eight, nine, and hold it up. 10 pulses. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Rest it. Okay, other side. Shoulder right on top, legs out in front. Here's the slow ones. 10.
Switch.
Bring these hands back, clasp your hands together, and open up that chest. Release, take a deep breath, inhale. And exhale, let that tension out of your head, neck, and shoulders. Shake them out. And you are done. Thank you guys so much for joining me. Hope to see you guys soon.